All right, Mojo in the Morning, home of the phone scams. And we have somebody that's on the phone that's actually wanting us to scam somebody here. Yep. And what's your name?
My name is Ray.
Ray, what does Ray want to do, Spike?
Ray wants us to phone scam a new employee. Is that right, Ray?
My name's Kyra, brand new employee.
Oh, boy.
What do you guys do?
We sell luggage. It's a luggage shop in the mall.
I always wondered how those luggage shops in the mall ever make it.
It's not really an impulse buy, is it?
Yeah.
Well, I'll tell you what. We'll do the scam only because you've been harassing our interns all morning on the phone.
What's your idea for the scam?
What I'm thinking I'll do is call her and try and buy some luggage, but see if she'll help me modify it first.
And then?
And then, well, the feds will come in and bust her for terrorism, obviously.
Hang up the phone. Let her answer it, okay?
Okay, yeah.
Hang up.
Here's another Mojo in the Morning phone scam.
Good morning, thanks for calling. This is Kyra speaking. How may I help you?
Hey, how you doing? Do you guys sell any carry-on luggage that's like regulation airline size but has wheels?
We have hard case ones, and then we have, you know, this soft side was considered nylon material.
Perfect. How late are you guys open today if I came down there?
Till 9. We're here till 9.
Okay. One more question. On this case, would you be able to put holes in it?
With the nylon or the hard side?
The hard case. Like, could you cut holes in the side, or would you need to use a drill?
You probably would have to use a drill to put holes in it.
What about you guys?
What about us? Will we be able to put holes in it?
Yeah.
No.
Like, if I paid you double the cost of the suitcase, would you be able to put a couple holes in it for me? Like, just like breathing holes, you know, let the air out the contents of the bag?
I honestly do not know. That's the first time I've ever been asked this question.
Oh, really?
Yes.
Because I could do it myself, but I'm in a hurry, and I just want to pick up the bag on my way to the airport.
I understand, but no, I don't think we won't be able to do that at all. We don't have an old drill or anything.
I'm offering $400 for the bag, and you guys just cut a couple holes in the sides for me. Keep the change.
Sir, I honestly don't know. I don't see us doing that, but... What time you plan on coming?
Probably like 6 o'clock tonight.
Okay. What's your number?
Well, if I give you my credit card number, you can just run the card and then.
We don't even have a drill or anything to put holes in your bag. Mm. So.
What about a pair of scissors or something? Just give it a good stabbing. A prison shank.
If you could, you could buy it and you could put the holes in your luggage yourself.
Yeah, I just won't have time. I'm gonna have to run right to the airport.
If you want holes in your luggage, then as soon as you purchase it, we can give you a pair of scissors and you can do it yourself.
So you would let me do it there in the store at least?
I guess it's your luggage. If after you purchase it, if you want to put holes in your luggage, then I guess you can do that. You paid for it already.
Okay. What was your name again?
Kyra.
Kyra?
Yes.
Let me be honest with you, Kyra. My name's Detective Ethan Tremblay. I'm calling from the FAA.
Yes.
Right now we're doing a bust on companies that do this, and we have a little bit of a problem between you and I. Because you just said you would allow me to put breathing holes in luggage right there in your store.
That's what you're saying, that you want to do it.
Right, but you're willing to help a customer smuggle a child or a terrorist onto an airplane.
No, I would not.
You said I could use your scissors right there in the store to alter the airline's luggage. You were willing to put our country at risk for a few dollars there.
No, I wouldn't have. That's your luggage. Like what I said to you, if that's what you want to do with your luggage,
right?
Then that's what you can do. But
you were encouraging me to use your scissors in your store there and everything.
No, I wasn't. I said that's what you want to do, then that's what you can do. But
ma'am, you could be facing charges right now. And I'll be honest with you, I'm not going to read your rights because obviously this is something new to you. You're a first-time offender. So what I'll do is I'm just going to get you to promise that you'll never do this again.
I promise I'll never do it again.
Okay, and we'll just put you on warning.
Okay.
All right. So if you'll just repeat after me, I swear to the United States and Canada.
I swear to the United States and Canada.
That I will promote safe domestic and international travel.
I will promote safe international and domestic travel.
And I will uphold safe luggage use for all passengers.
I will uphold safe luggage use for passengers.
And that the children will fly to South America in a normal seat, not in a carry-on bag.
And children in South America will fly in a normal seat and not in a carry-on bag.
Amen.
Amen.
This is Spike from the Mojo in the Morning Show, and you've just been phone scammed.
Oh, my God.
Was that the oddest request you ever had from a customer?
The weirdest.
Well, it's not really the FAA. You're on with Mojo.
Thank you.
Repeat after me. I've just been phone scammed.
I've just been phone scammed.
By Mojo in the morning.
By Mojo in the morning. Oh, my God.
We will scam you. Your home of the phone scams, Mojo in the morning.
Attention.
This is Mojo in the morning.
You're listening to Mojo in the morning.